Hi and welcome to the Blue Screen Brothers. In this episode I will take a look into Entra application and if you should use owner or cloud application administrator to give extended permissions to Entra app registration and enterprise apps. Let's start with owner. The owner role are permanently active and it can currently not be assigned to anything else than the user, no group assignment. You will have possibility to do almost anything with application, like deleting it, give other user and groups access, or block access. You can also create new secrets. We will show it a little bit later. Cloud Application Administrator on the other side can actually use Privileged Identity Management, PIM, and in that way it can require activation, it can be added to groups, so you have the possibility to add the extra layer of needing approval to get the permission roles, and you can also limit the time when the role are active. The permissions is just about the same, but you also have some extra permissions like Azure Service Health Insight. You can create Azure support tickets, and you can also read more logs and reports in the admin center, making it easier when you troubleshoot. There are a common misunderstanding that this is a global permission that will make you a cloud application administrator on all the applications in the entire enterprise, but that's not true. You can actually go in and just give the role to a single application or service principle if you want it. So let's take a deeper look into how we do it. So let's go into Entra and have a look at applications. I have created two different applications, one with the owner and one with PIM for a user. Let's go into the owner one and start with that one. We'll see I have an owner called Adele. So Adele is the owner of this application. So let's take a look on how Adele can use it by opening an in-private browser with Adele's information. So I have logged on as Adele and I have gone into the Entra portal with Adele as well. And if I go into app registration, she will now appear with one application as owner. So it's easy to find your own owned applications. If we go in here, we can see that Adele had a possibility to go into secret, new client secret, and create the secret. Let it last for 2 years and add. And of course, she can copy the value now and she will have the secret active for 2 years during this setup. So now we have made it possible for Adele to actually use this secret to do whatever she wants to do. She can go into app permissions and grant permission, but she cannot grant permissions that she is not allowed to grant. So there are limitations there, but she can add new owners. If she wants to add new owner, she can remove owners. She can remove permissions if they have permissions. She can basically do whatever she wants to do in here, and she can also go into the enterprise application and do stuff like adding groups on a different way she want to do it. Assign, and she can do a lot more in here. So there are a lot of ways for Adele to really make a problem with the application. One of the things you can do is, for instance, go into properties and change the settings to assignment required or turn off the sign in. So she can do a lot of different thing in here. So now we can see that Adele could do this without any other kind of permissions. Let's switch back and just take a quick look at the application I created called Demo PIM, And in demo PIM, we can see that Adele is not an owner. We don't have any owner at all. So she cannot use the owner part in here. But you have roles and administrator, where you can see that cloud application administrator can do stuff on this application. So let's see how it looks when Adele is trying to go in and find that application. So we need to go to all applications. She will see the demo PIM, but she cannot do anything because she doesn't have permissions. She can go into certificate and secrets. She cannot add any secrets or do anything that we don't want her to do. So I want to make sure that Adele should be allowed to be a global admin here on the application. So I will go back to the setup. And usually we are used to using identity governance, privileged identity management, and manage entry roles. Going into role, find a cloud administrator. And here we can see that we have the mod administrator that's already in here. That can be a cloud application administrator, and the scope is directory. So we want to scope it down to be just the application and not the entire directory. So then we just go to add assignment. And we can see that the role are selected and the scope type is directory, but we will change it down to application. Select scope and find the demo PIM application. Select it. Select the member, Adele. Select and next. She could be reliable, active, and permanent reliable. We can give her the reliability to activate it for a certain amount of time. For instance, we just want to make sure she just have it for a couple of weeks maybe. So let's set it to be just 30th of June, assign, and now we have given her the possibility to activate the role from now on and until the date selected. So it will only work in the scope of the demo application. So if we go back to Adele, you can see that she needs to activate her role. She don't have any permissions. Let's go down to the identity governance, privilege identity management, my roles, and this is of course an Entra role. And then you can see she have gotten the cloud application administrator. She can activate it and select how much time and give us a reason to some changes. Activated. And the good thing is now is she will only have the role for selected time, a maximum of 8 hours. We can have just adjusted that down if we wanted to. And we could also have added extra step in the approval of the role. So some admin have to approve her to get the role. So it will not be an instant assignment. Let's go back to the application app registration. And we will see demo PIM. She can now add owner, add owners. She can add certificates. She can even delete the applications if she want to. So we have now given her the PIM possibility to be an admin in here. There are also a different way of assigning the role if you want to see it on a different way, different scope. For instance, we might want to do it on the enterprise application instead. And then I need to go back to my Olav account and go into the application. This time I will go into the enterprise applications and we have the demo PIM. And in here we have roles and administrators. Cloud application administrator, and if I click on that one now, I can actually go in and select add assignments. Also here we can see the settings for the assignment if we want to do some changes. For instance, only allow 1 hour, require MFA, don't make it possible to have it permanent if we want to, and just update it. Notification will send email to the different parts like the approver, assignee, and admin if you want to go through that process. So let's update that one and add an assignment. You can see now its scope type is service principal, and the selected scope is the demo pane, and we will like to add Adele. Select, next. Not permanent, the same way. Let's go up and give her the same permissions for the same, just about the same amount of time. Like that. Assign. Refresh. Go into Allowable, and then we will see that Adele has been added. And let's go back to Adele's PIM console, my roles, and we will see now she have two parts that almost look the same, but application is the app registration, but and demo PIM service principal is the enterprise apps, that's the service principal of the object, and she can activate it here for only 1 hour. So that's just how we can assign by using PIM and the role instead of using owner. And in my opinion, it makes it safer because we don't have the possibility to always do changes. We need to activate the role before we can do changes. And we can add the extra layer of approval if we want to make sure that somebody else will have to say that you are allowed to do these changes. So this makes it quite more secure and quite easy to set up. So I hope this was something you will consider to use instead of the owner role. So, bye.